Hold on, let me pull something up real quick.
Two.
Bring us a Nick today.
We are live.
Welcome back to the Surface Wave Podcast. I am Nicholas.
Lalo over here. What's up, everybody?
And our producer, Nikki.
Yeah, boy.
Yeah, boy.
You said you were going to pull something up?
Yeah,
by the way, Celsius, if you guys want to sponsor us.
Yeah, hit us up.
I mean, what do you want? I'm just showing them, you know, look at that.
Ooh, that's a...
God damn, that was really good. That
was nice. I'm saying, dude.
Celsius, use that for your commercials, for your, like, little ad-lib thingies, you know?
You're welcome.
Could you imagine they hit us up, they're like, never do it again?
Yeah. So
they don't want to sponsor us at all.
We're going to ask you to never do that again, please.
No, but once again, happy December.
Happy December, everybody.
As you see, I'm wearing I Am Saint Nick.
Are you guys excited for Christmas?
Oh, yeah. Big time Christmas
guy
over here,
dude. My son's been all over it, dude.
Yeah?
This is the first time he's actually acknowledged
it. Oh, that's cool.
And he's just like, Christmas, all day, dude.
Oh, yeah. We have like a, I want to say probably like a 2 foot tall, like Santa Claus decoration, and my son loves it, dude.
That's awesome.
He's always like, Santa. And like, he picks it up and holds it like a baby. He loves Big Santa, bro.
What's the evil version of Santa?
Krampus.
Yeah. I finally watched that show. Like that movie. Like,
what'd you think of it?
It's nuts.
It's kind of fucking crazy,
it's
bro.
It's cool though. I love horror Christmas stuff.
Mm-hmm. There's like a whole like Krampus Claus thing going on in like that fucking haunted house thing in Caldwell.
Oh, that's cool.
The Requiem.
That's cool. Oh, so they turned it like kind of a Christmas theme.
Yeah, Christmas. Then. It's like a Krampus theme.
That's cool.
Krampus.
I mean, it's up to you guys. We want to pronounce.
I like Kramp.
Is it other like cultures like in Germany? They have like Santa as evil. I could be totally wrong.
No, just like I think Krampus is their evil Santa. So if you're not good, then Krampus comes to smack that ass.
I mean, if you want to scare the shit out of your children, you say Krampus is going to smack that ass.
Could you imagine? You know what? Krampus is going to come smack that ass.
That's a shirt. Oh, smack that.
Somebody shirt that.
No, Christmas. Oh, and then like you're saying, we put a little 2 foot. We have a little 2 foot tree.
Oh,
it's our Christmas tree. Okay. So the presents look cooler around it.
I like
so
that.
So they're huge. But yeah.
You got your tree. Oh, yeah. So your tree set up. Nikki, do you got your tree set up?
I do. I have a nice white tree.
Oh, I like that. Dude.
Ooh.
That I've had for like the past 2 years. It's still in good condition if you guys want to buy it. You know, I'll get a new one.
How much would you sell it for, you think?
Honestly, $20.
What's the lowest you'd go for it?
$20.
All right. Let's see if somebody could talk Nikki down to 15.
What, Facebook Marketplace or what? Where'd you get this?
No, I just text him.
No, I got it brand new. I didn't get no deal on this one. Wow. Yeah, $20.
Okay.
There's no going down on it.
We'll see.
My price.
I haven't got my tree yet because we do. We like to get the real Christmas tree.
You're doing real?
Yeah. That's so dope. Like we always do like them. 2 weeks, 2.5 weeks before Christmas, because it's kind of a bitch to maintain.
Those
like,
pine needles.
Last year I didn't water it enough, and like it was kind of like droopy by Christmas, and I was like, never again.
Then you gotta saw it off on the bottom of this fucking thing.
But there's nothing better than the smell of it in the house, though, because that shit is
dude. It's the coolest candle.
Facts.
And it won't burn your house.
I heard
down.
If you go to Idaho City. You get a tree for $10 and you just go chop it down.
Oh,
yourself.
Yeah. And you get like you have to get like a little permit.
Yeah, tree tag, like if it was a deer or something.
I got my tag this year.
Got my deer tag or my tree tag.
Tree tag. Fine oak. Fine. On the thing, when you were younger, did you ever put like army guys in the Christmas tree?
Oh, hell yeah, dude. I was always hiding weird shit.
Dude, because I got the inspiration from Toy Story, the first one where they're hiding in the plants.
Right.
So then I got like put in the tree, just like, and then the parachute when you get from like, Boondocks or
the parachuter guy.
Yeah, the parachuter guys.
Oh, yeah.
It's so cool. And then your fucking cat just tears it down.
Oh, dude, cats are the worst when it comes to Christmas. They don't give a shit about anything.
One time I was all excited, like sleeping next to the Christmas tree, and then I woke up and my left eye was just swollen. Like I don't know if something like a bug fucked my eye or something
Jesus.
Like that, or like a pine got in there. But my mom, I thought it was all fine. Like, I thought my eyes was just tired. But then I walk up to my mom, like, I'm ready for school. She's like, what the fuck's wrong with you? I'm like, what?
And
like,
Krampus smacked your ass. Well,
yeah. And then I looked into the mirror, though, and I was petrified. I'm like, oh, shit.
I'm dying.
It looked like I just got in a fight. So, but I got out of school.
I like that. Bad. A good way to get out of school, for sure.
It's weird, though, when you skip school. You think you're going to have the best day, but you're like, this is boring as shit.
It sucks ass most of the time, right?
Yeah.
It's just like the most boring day at home. Like nobody's home. Like your parents go to work. Like what am I doing?
Yeah,
here?
And then like the first day I've ever skipped school ever was in college. Of course, when I paid for it.
Right.
So like, for some reason, high school I went perfect attendance, and then college I'm like, I'll quit.
You know what? I'm not going.
But like same thing. I drove And then I'm like, I drove back. And then I just at house and nothing happened. And so I'm like, this is stupid. I should have just went. And I'm paying for school.
Bro, I used to do that all the time. Like, I'd pull up to like my math class and just kind of sit there and be like, not today.
God, I hate. You know what's the worst is falling asleep in class. And then you wake up and you're like, or you ever have that feeling when you're, you feel like if you're not asleep, you're not asleep yet, but you're like almost about to sleep and you're like visioning like riding a bike or a scooter and you fall off and then your head jerks and then everyone looks at you. I'm like, oh, you're shit, like,
what?
Yeah, that's the worst. falling asleep in class.
I've done that so many times. It's not even funny.
Did you guys ever skip school?
No, I was too scared.
I did like a handful of times, but I was also like too, I was a chicken, bro.
Dude, I got caught one time, dude. So I used to walk to school. I lived like, it was like down a hill.
Okay.
And it was like 11, 12. And I was like, fuck this, dude, I'm going home. And I started walking up the hill and I started running up the hill, you know? I was trying to, you know, like the overpass going towards Caldwell?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I was walking through there, that little catwalk area. And when I got to the end of that fucking catwalk, there is the cop and there's the fucking principal waiting for me right
what?
There.
Damn.
They're like, you have two options. You could either go home and get kicked out of school or you could walk back. I was like, you guys can't even give me a ride?
I was like, I know, for real.
I'd have been like, I don't know, be like, hey, I swear I thought school was this way.
I must have got turned around somehow. I don't know how that happened.
I didn't park my car here.
It was so much bullshit.
Damn, so you had to walk all the way back to school.
Damn, so you did young. I was too petrified. I was like, not having that. My mom didn't even know, but I was like too scared to even have an open period.
Well, I see.
I was like, I'm just going to stay at school even though I'm failing. So it doesn't make sense.
That's the thing, man. I didn't want to skip school and have my mom find out and have her just beat my ass. Like, that was the worst thing. Like, she was just like, go to school and just do it. It's not that hard. All right, cool. But like, school sucks, mom.
Dude, when your parents, like, they've spanked you before, right?
Oh, for sure.
And Krampus spanked that ass, too. Yeah, but like,
Krampus got my ass at least once.
I think I got spanked by a belt once, and I was a little shit, too. Because okay. I was in my next one, we were leaving my house, and like, Nick, you could come back. But I'm like, almost threw my friend's controller down. I'm like, I hate you. And then I would go to my parents' house crying like a little bitch. And then suddenly my dad's like, had enough.
He's like, hell no.
He's like, get on the couch right now, face the wall. I'm like, wait, what?
assume the position.
I'm like, it never happened before. I'm like, wait, what the fuck? So then suddenly I just hear the bell like crack. And I'm like, oh, shit. And then I was never a piece of shit ever after that.
I thought this was only in movies.
Yeah, and then my mom was like threatened to like spank me and stuff, but then I laugh it off.
Right, yeah.
One time she hit me with like a comb.
Oh, like that.
Like hit me, and then I'm like, mom, it doesn't hurt.
Well, that's like the only time like I got a, like, I always kind of got like a little whooping, pow.
Yeah.
But like the one time I remember specifically is my mom came at me with a belt, and she whooped my ass. Like, wow. And like you hear it coming
through,
like, shh, boom, and like I hit it, and like I only cried because I was terrified. I went to my room, and I shut the door, and I was like, that didn't even fuck her, son.
Yeah, you're just adrenaline pumping. You're like just pacing in the room.
You're screaming in the pillow. I hate
you. I know. Oh, God. Nick, you ever been hit?
Yeah, bro, most definitely.
Yeah,
plenty of times, dude. My dad used to whoop my ass.
And it's like, I'm not saying like it's, you know, just hit your children.
Yeah,
but
we weren't abused.
But like, yeah,
we were shitbags.
Like, really nice corrected. What was it mean, like, being corrected? Like, just don't act like a little punk.
Dude, the thing that my mom did, dude, she hurt me verbally with words, bro.
Oh damn.
Dude, she
you're
like,
not going to make it in life.
No, not even that. just like, why are you doing that? And damn. She was just like, talking.
Oh, the disappointment.
Yeah, the disappointment. I'm just like, I'm sorry, dude. Like, that would make me fucking just feel hurt.
She's like breaking your heart, dude. Yeah, that's rough.
The disappointment card is always.
My mom was a big
mom.
Yeah, was that? Moms are the only ones that could use that, bro. My mom's like, what are you doing?
They're word ninjas.
You're better than this. Yeah. I'm like, am I like, better?
Actually, before my mom starts like making me depressed, I'm like, I'm just gonna have dad hit me.
Don't talk. You know what? I'm okay. Dad, come. Krampus,
yeah,
come get this ass.
Dress down, mom.
You're good to go.
Dad, you can take the lead on this one.
or the classic move when you like your dad says or your mom says, ask your dad, And then they're like, mom said yes.
Right.
Like, this tricket.
Just push it, petting them against each other.
Yep.
Oh, yeah, dude.
Yeah. That's why they're divorced.
Just kidding. That was me. Sorry.
That
was me.
That time the kid was wrong.
Just kidding. How's everybody's week with Nick? Nick, I see you said you got a feeling something's good going to happen.
I don't know. I don't know if it's just like the Christmas spirit or the holiday spirit, but I just feel like, I don't know. I feel like something good's going to come. I don't know why. Well, It's a weird feeling.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I've seen on Twitter you've been fucking Mr. Beast Jr.
You should change
your Twitter name to Mr. Beast Jr. See if that works.
I mean, it could get some looks. Well, the crazy thing is, though, like this last one, the last tweet, like 1,500 people looked at it, and only 20 people liked it.
Well, yeah, but
just it's $25 too low.
Yeah, Nick's doing a giveaway on Twitter, so follow him on Twitter at
Pacheck this tweet.
Yeah, link in the bio.
Thank you. Thank you. Also, if you want to play it with me on PlayStation, Pacheck yourself. Also.
Ooh, yes, find him on PS.
Mm-hmm.
Oh yeah, the branding. But then I'm just Nick Pacheco on YouTube, so I need to change that. But yeah, I just been. But it's cool. Like we just did it yesterday too. And then shout out Callie, my girlfriend. She wanted to match me. So then we picked two winners and stuff. And
I know,
it's just cool.
I didn't
to
even get an intern. I was fucking sad about it.
Hey, I'm thinking of doing it every Friday.
Okay, Friday giveaways with Mr. Beast Jr.
Yeah.
Nick Pacheco.
That sounds dope.
Yeah.
But yeah, I just, I don't know, just something about like, it doesn't even have to be a big feeling. I just feel like it's doing it. Oh, is a fly, is an ad attacking you?
Yeah.
Is it a mosquito or is it a fly?
I think it's a mosquito.
Dude, how?
It's the last living one, dude, of its kind.
Just the last one.
Where is he at? Hold
he's on. Up there. He's chilling up there now.
Yeah. You get away.
You stay the fuck up there.
Mister.
Mr. Beast Jr.
No, I think it's a cool. It's a cool.
Yeah, idea. It's dope that you do it. And it's cool that people are like, I've seen that you've posted like the messages you've got or you showed us too. Like everyone's so thankful.
It's true.
It's like, cool, it's, man.
And then we did the thing where we checked the background. Like we want to make sure they're not like too crazy, but we, just want to make sure they don't see some crazy shit.
Right.
To get them. But they're all been thankful. Everything's been good.
It's a cool thing to do, man. I have some cool news, dudes.
What is it?
I'm going to be a girl dad.
Woo!
Hey.
Hashtag girl dad.
Yes. Thank you. I want to give a huge shout out to my man, Craze, and his lady, Esther, and the whole Wave Image Studios company for taking the time to capture that special moment for us, man, especially because the day that we did our little gender reveal, we just popped the balloon. I'll show you guys, but it was so foggy outside, and like the sun was going down, and like we were kind of worried, we're kind of worried about it. Yeah, but he just crushed it, bro. Like, he's such a professional. If you guys need anything, family reunions, gender reveals, parties, weddings, anything, hit my man up, bro, because he'll knock it out the park for you. Like, here, you can cut to the laptop.
You need music videos, studio sets, everything.
Everything,
dude.
Music
my
videos.
Man, I've been working with him for like almost 3 years now, and dude, man's just been able to perfect anything. So
that being said, we love you. We love you, Craze.
We fucking love you, dog.
All right, let's watch this real quick, and let's all cry together.
Fucking model looking like a snack, dude.
Thanks, bro. My son was not having it, by the way, bro.
Those pictures of your son, he's like, what?
Look at him, he's just pissed off.
He's all, I want to go play.
He's like, this is cool.
Oh, dude, that's fucking amazing.
Aww.
I'm just hopping along.
Your son's like, what?
He's always going
it's kind of, when I popped the balloon, it scared him, poor guy. He's so pissed.
That's beautiful, dude. That's fucking beautiful.
Thank you, bro. Craze, they killed him and this lady has to set it up
the
for
fog
us.
The fog just gives it a little extra, just...
It is cool. Yeah.
Crying. Yeah, so
aww. So Lalo's okay. Crying, big whoop.
Look at that, dude.
Yeah, it came out amazing, bro. He's amazing.
He just captured
He's
it.
A wizard, bro.
Is it appropriate to say I got nipple chills?
Yeah, okay. You can say that.
Okay.
God, that's so cool. Yeah, there it is, man. I'm a girl dad coming to be.
Damn, so that means what the due date is? I'm not good at math.
The due date right now is beginning of May, I believe.
Oh, shit.
Dang.
Mm-hmm.
May
Hell
baby.
Yeah, dude.
The thing about like that is we have my family, and I guess my wife's family also has a lot of birthdays in April.
Oh, okay.
So we're hoping May kind of spread it out a little bit.
Yeah.
But the thought is it's most my daughter's most likely gonna steal somebody's birthday.
you're like sorry
guys.
Priority.
Sorry guys.
It could have been anyone.
Well, that's the first girl, right?
Yeah, my first girl.
Yeah, that's
well,
cool.
Like,
granddaughter.
Granddaughter for like your mother-in-law.
Maybe.
No, I don't know if I could. Maybe if I can't say this, Chris, just cut it out. No, because my little sister-in-law Destiny's having a daughter as well.
Ooh.
See, so
shout out Destiny.
One of them will have the daughter, the very first granddaughter.
Oh, it's
born.
A battle.
My wife or my sister-in-law.
You just gotta
battle the sisters.
Make like a 3D model of your daughter. Mm-hmm. Just have it like sit it like that. Like
we win.
You win. Oh, that'd be cool. God, I can't imagine having a kid. That'd be so cool.
Yeah, it's awesome, man. It's a really cool feeling. Like, I'm so excited. I'm so beyond pumped. It's amazing, man. Being a father is the best like feeling in the world. Anybody that has a kid or like has their ladies pregnant, like I get so excited for them because it's life changing, man. Like life just gets better.
Do you feel like you're on top? Oh,
I Miyagi'd that.
I didn't even get that.
Yeah, but you might have caught it though in the background, maybe, hopefully.
I got that Oh, what's up?
Then that's dad-like reflexes right there.
Just like that. I can only do that because I'm a father.
You're looking Nick straight in the eyes when you did that.
I was talking to him. Boom!
Yeah, you're like, let me finish this thought.
real quick. Ah!
I swear to God, my grandma caught a fly with chopsticks.
No way.
I swear to God. And I thought it was just like insane.
Damn.
I know. And like that, it just brought me back.
Is your grandma tough as nails?
She's tough as bamboo.
Yeah, there we go.
Yes.
Yeah, because like you're talking about how she's just kind of like when you play guitar, she's like, it's okay.
Yeah, she's just really
just rough around the edges.
The worst was the magic tricks.
Oh, okay.
I fucking mess up and she's like, all right. And then I go right back upstairs. So like, gotta go back to the lab.
Fuck. You're in the mirror like stupid.
Dude,
stupid,
I swear, magic was so cool back then.
Do you still do magic?
No, but every once I still know like a few card tricks.
Cool.
But like I saw Chris Angel, so I was just mind blown. But
yeah, so you're in the room trying to levitate.
My mind got freaked.
Oh, my mind's been freaked a few times.
Oh, that funny that levitation trick where you barely lift your foot.
Yeah, yeah.
I once got freaked out.
It works.
My dad cut like a slit in the pants, like so he could put his leg out in front of the stairs. So it looked like he was actually levitating.
Smart.
I'm like, what the fuck?
That's some real dad shit.
Dads can float. I want to float.
They can, actually. I could attest. Me and Nikki both, right, Nikki? We could float?
You could float. You know, like, if you go in the pool, you know, you got that beer belly, you know, let it float.
Maybe your beer belly comes out of nowhere.
Maybe if you're Pennywise, we all float down here.
Oh, Georgie. Shit. That's a scary dad.
Hiya, Georgie.
Hi, Georgie.
You like popcorn?
Pennywise.
Oh, shit. I don't like popcorn, Pennywise. Fuck off.
Fuck off.
Keep the stupid bitch boat.
Yeah, what if you just... None of the kids actually say no. They're just curious. Like, if just say no.
Popcorn sucks, Georgie.
Did you like it?
Yeah, I didn't mind it. It was kind of, like, cheesy, but, like, you just kind of expect that type of stuff, I feel like.
It's better than the remake, I think. Or
the original?
The original.
Yeah, well, that... I like most remakes just because like everything's the acting's better, the quality of the shots are better. Most remakes.
Yeah.
I think they should. I watched The Outsiders the other day.
Oh.
They should remake that movie, I think.
Oh, so you're just on board with the reboots and
remakes. I like reboots. Who does? And then
yeah, it's cool to see.
I feel like if you don't, then you're just like if you don't like reboots, and I get it, like whatever. But you're kind of a gatekeeper.
Is there some that they shouldn't touch at all?
I think. Maybe, yeah, like, I don't feel like they should ever touch the Godfather trilogy.
Oh, whoa. I would never even think of rebooting. Yeah, that'd be true.
You kind
of
have to leave that alone. Maybe, okay. Like, Made in Manhattan. Leave that one alone. I don't know why that came to my head.
Hey, I mean, it's stuck
but
with
don't,
you.
Don't yeah, you don't fucking touch it. Don't ever. I don't think I've even seen it.
Your wife's like, what's wrong? You're like, just fucking Made in Manhattan reboot.
I'm just pouting at the... God damn it.
What news did you just find out?
Yeah. Are you okay?
Hey, in theaters, though, we still got to see Spider-Man.
It's coming. When is that, next week?
I think so. Yeah, 17th,
is it?
Yeah, exactly
next
a week.
We're going, right?
I think we go.
Nikki, you're down?
I want to go see
Let's
it.
Vlog yeah. it. Let's vlog it. Let's like what you
Yo,
said we could
pay. Is your son in a spot? Is your son in a...
Vlog it, dude. We're going to get kicked out.
No, we're going to... I know. We're going to pirate the whole fucking movie.
I'll put my...
For Patreon.
I'll put my phone right here.
I'm not recording, I swear.
You're like, this is part of the shirt.
Hey, stop.
Is your son into superheroes and stuff, Nikki? Would he be down to go? Would he sit?
No, he wouldn't, dude. He'd just be like jumping
around. Give me your phone, Dad.
Yeah, basically. Be like,
right, but have the movie on the iPhone, too.
Yeah, see, there we go. So we're going for sure.
Yo, he's watched... The amount of times that I've watched The Grinch in these past 2 days is unbelievable.
Which Grinch movie? Which one?
The newest one.
Okay. Oh,
dude, I swear to you, yesterday I watched it 3 times back to back.
Holy shit.
Back to back, dude.
Yo, kids are crazy that way.
I was like, hey, you want to watch something else? No. Grinch. I'm like, you want to watch it again? yeah.
Yeah, Dad.
I'm like, okay. And every single time he'd be like, oh, look, a tree. Dude, the same parts, but you just want to watch those.
He's gonna start like mouthing the words.
Oh, next thing, well, what if you come? He comes out of the room and he's like just full Grinch character.
Dude, he was singing like this morning, because we turn off our Christmas tree,
mm-hmm.
and at night, he first thing in the morning he walks to the tree, bro.
Oh, that's
cool. He'll turn it on, he'll sit down with his blanket, he'll ask me for some water, and he's like, Grinch, I want to watch the Grinch, Dad.
I'm like, damn, your son, dude, come on, he's super Christmas right now, bro. He's dude, all he's all the way in the Christmas spirit.
Dude, he is.
I love like, that.
Just everything. Oh. just cool. Everything. He was just like, just Christmas, dude. Everything he sees is like, he's really into it right now.
That's dope, man. Speaking of Christmas, on our Patreon exclusive, we did a Christmas movie tier list. And if you click the cut to laptop, here's a little, I'll give you guys a little taste. A little taste, bro.
Oh, yeah.
Ooh, the new opening for the Patreon so fire.
Patreon.
Make sure to tune in to find out who won in our opinion. Charlie. Oh, yeah, you're very aggressive.
Yeah, right? What the fuck is up, Patreon?
You're way more aggressive. I don't know.
It was off, dude.
Hey, let's go up so we can see. Give a little what we're doing here.
The traps are even cooler in that one, I think.
Let me know how many stains you could find on my shirt.
He's not in it. There's that. Let's let it play a little bit, right? Give it a little tiny taste.
Make sure to drop in the comment what you guys think is your favorite Christmas movie.
Yeah, let us know what your favorite Christmas movie is. Get out of here. You guys are going to see anything else.
Follow the Patreon.
Yeah. Oh, also, I have another announcement. Speaking of the Patreon, So we're trying to hit a Patreon goal of 15 patrons.
Okay.
And we're at 10 now. So if we get 5 more patrons, we'll let our patrons help us choose the next design for our Surface Wave Patreon exclusive shirts.
Oh, that's
so
dope.
The patrons will be able to help us decide what the next shirt's going to look like. So
that's sweet.
Tell everybody, let's get there. Let's hit the goal of 15. That'll be tremendous.
And then what was our promo too? Like if you get just the $5?
Yeah, so we have for our Patreon tiers, we have a $5 tier, a $10, $15, $5, $15, and $25 dollar tier. But for the month of December, we'll say, or until we hit our 15 goal, if you sign up for Patreon, you will get the whole VIP package, even if you just sign up for the $5 tier.
Hell yeah.
So you get everything. Yeah. That's a shirt, a mug, or a cup of your choice, which is a mug, a wine glass, or a coffee cup,
mm-hmm.
And then a sticker bundle, and I think that's it.
Hell yeah. And only for $5?
Yeah, and only $5. It's a hell of a deal because the quality of the shirts, the quality of the mugs, coffee cups, and... wine glasses, everything is top notch.
Yeah.
We put a lot of work and love into these things. So signing up for $5 to get the whole VIP package is really a steal.
Yeah, bring Surface Wave cheer.
Yeah. So once again,
to a house near you.
Yeah, right.
a lot of the stuff was like a lot of stuff we did by
hand. Handmade.
I'm not saying me, but it was Lalo and Cruz and
our ladies.
Their ladies.
That's dope.
And the shirts. The shirts they look so good.
Oh, Nick can attest. We got you. You got your,
hell yeah,
yourself
I got
a package.
I've been drinking out of that mug.
Oh, I love have the mug is my favorite.
That's my official Oktoberfest mug. Also,
yes. So
yeah. You got to see this sucker.
Great. So yeah, man. If you sign up for $5 tier, you get the whole VIP package. And if we hit our goal of 15 patrons, all of the patrons will have a choice to help us decide the next brand or the next design for the next Surface Wave shirt.
Oh yeah.
Bingo, baby. Bingo. Let's go.
Bing bong.
Bing bong. Bing bong.
You know, I thought that was a minion at first.
Oh, see, that makes sense.
Bing bong.
It could be a minion.
Maybe. Like
Undertaker.
I thought somebody's going to
walk in. The lights cut out.
You see Crazes walk in.
Oh, my God.
Done.
Oh, my God. Haunted house? Oh, my God. It's
Nick on the table.
It's the Undertaker.
Dude, backyard brawls.
It's going to be a slobber locker.
Backyard wrestling.
Backyard wrestling.
Did you guys see the teaser for the next Harry Potter?
No, I saw
the Return to Hogwarts, baby.
Have you guys watched all the Harry Potters?
Yes.
I haven't seen the last one.
What?
I haven't seen
what are you
any
doing?
Of them.
Hey,
It's the NES.
Hold on, I think it's I think it's worse. You haven't seen the last one, Nick. What do you do?
It's I don't know. I never.
I think he expects that of me. But
No. Here's the thing. It's because Nick's like invested into the series. He's watched all the movies except for the. That's way worse than never watching them at all.
I've never watched Lord of the Rings either.
Either? What the fuck? Do you have something against that?
Or The Hobbit?
Do you hate trilogies?
Do you hate super long movies?
No, I like super long movies. I've just never, like, it's never caught my attention. I wanted to, but I've just never, like, I see it, then I'm just like, I'm going to watch Family Guy, you know? Like,
oh, that makes sense. I get that, bro, because especially with The Lord of the Rings, you're making a fucking, like, commitment, because I think all of them are, like, almost 3 hours long.
I think I skipped my grandma's funeral for Lord of the Rings.
Damn, bro.
you're really like, committed.
Shout out to Aragorn.
I'm like, I was like, they gotta fucking find this ring or Frodo.
Shout out to Frodo, bro.
They throw it in.
Yeah, so you, damn. I can't leave you watch that.
Wait, have you seen all the Star Wars?
I've never seen it.
Danny? Just watch the new trilogy.
That makes me a little angry.
This is what I'll promise you guys. What would you guys recommend?
Start with Harry Potter.
Harry Potter?
Yeah, start with Harry Potter.
Okay. Yeah, because then your son could like it too.
Yeah.
Like on the side.
Harry Potter is a good one.
Nobody judge me. What's up? This is me trying to better myself as a person.
Expanding his power.
All right. A lot of people think that. Never mind, but I'm going to try it next week. I'm going to watch, this week, I'm going to watch him.
It'll come
and
back.
You guys could question me. How about more, that?
Oh, we'll run a quiz.
The more likes this video gets, the more most likely Nikki will watch Lord of the Rings.
Right.
So, or Harry Potter. Harry Potter
first. Yeah, so if we're getting up to like 15 likes, Nikki's definitely going
to
watch
I'm just asking you to watch the first 5 movies by next week.
Oh, shit. It's doable, man. They're that good.
They're good.
That's 10 hours. 10 plus hours. 15?
Might be more.
Like 15 hours?
I think most of the Harry Potter movies are like two and a half hours, I'd say.
Yeah.
I think
the first one's really... The shortest one.
No, I think the 40. Fourth one is actually.
Okay.
It's like an hour 10.
What's one? Okay.
Or 30, something like that.
What's your favorite Harry Potter movie?
My favorite, I think, is I really like The Prisoner of Azkaban.
That one's dope.
But also The Goblet of Fire is a fucking absolute smacker.
Okay.
You get super in-depth into the magic world. Let's not spoil it for Nikki, but you do.
I watched that one in Japan, actually.
You were in Japan?
Yeah. Cause I'm quarter Japanese, Okinawan. Wait,
hold on. Hold on, man. why haven't you ever told us this?
Yeah, I didn't know you've been to Japan.
Dude, that was the first time I saw a cigarette vending machine. I was like, whoa.
I think next that's level. So crazy, dude. Like, kids could buy that.
Bro. Yeah, I was like, this is 100 yen. But then the coolest thing, it was called the Curry House.
Okay.
And it was...
Where it's where all the Steph Curry and his brothers live.
It was
live.
Like, yeah, it was co-owned. And I was just so... And I've already loved curry. So when I actually went to a professional curry house, I'm like, ooh. Holy cow. So I went in.
Curry, like fully curry
torqued.
Chicken?
Fully torqued. My mom's like, you got to put that shit away.
No, you can't come in here with this.
Yeah.
Can't you drink it public over there? Like, walk around
that
drinking?
That one I'm not sure, but I wouldn't be, you know.
They might chop your hand for that.
And this was back in 2007.
Okay.
So like things were, like I saw a full Pokemon airplane. Like it was decked out Pokemon. It was dope. But
damn, man.
And that was the first time I ever took a jumbo plane. That was crazy. And I was like, 11 hour flight.
Fuck.
That was bad.
How old are you?
It was going into eighth. It was after eighth grade year.
So like 15?
Like, 14, 15.
That's a long time, dude. 11 hour flight.
I was wearing my Echo Unlimited shirts and stuff. I was fucking fire.
Dude, honestly, fresh ass 11 fog. Hour flight would be totally worth it to go to Japan, dude.
100%.
Yeah, 100%. Yeah. But the flight there, they didn't have TVs on the back of the seats. Oh. It was only on the flight back. So I'm just bored as shit going. Just like,
yeah, dude, that sucks.
But sleeping on a plane is so uncomfortable.
Dude, it's hard to do.
My mom hates flying too. She's like white knuckling it. I'm like, it's going to be fine. Right. This is turbulence. As I'm just like, I have a concussion. Right. But at the curry house, it was the coolest service. It was, by the way, too, it was like the first time I ever saw outlets, like on by booths and stuff.
Okay, cool.
So I'm like, damn, these guys
are ahead of the times.
Yeah, ahead of time. But it, legit, when you're ready for your order, you push a button, and like 2 seconds, a waiter just comes out and like,
oh, take shit. Your order.
Like, it was so
That's
efficient.
Dope.
It was fast and efficient. But like, I remember. For the menus, it was 1 through 10 of spice, and I picked the 7 because I thought I could handle it. Oh. And my mom and my aunt, they did level 8s. Oh, and we were just
these are a spicy family.
We love it, but this one was like, fucking, they should have said something else. I don't know if Japan spicy is different from American spicy. But I was like, I ate it,
And I like fought through it, but like my nose is running in my mouth while I'm eating it. I'm mm-hmm. just like, I'm just recycling my snot. It's like eating. It was so rough, dude, but it was still the best.
10 out of 10 flavor.
So good. I love curry.
Damn, take
so
us
much.
To Japan.
Dude, I'll take you to Okinawa. That's
yeah, take us with you next time.
Then there's like, they it was so clean too. They like clean their streets like every week, I think. You just see a whole team.
Oh, that's nice.
And then the lawnmowers, it looked like a vacuum cleaner.
Really?
There's a funny picture of my uncle just like vacuuming his lawn. Like, it was so weird looking. It's
interesting.
So weird.
Do you guys feel like there's a lot of good of different countries, like things that we should take into consideration and do over here?
Ooh, yeah.
I feel like that, and there's a lot of stuff that we could, you know, that they could do that we do as well. But I feel like a majority of the things is like we could take something from them, you know, just use it over here.
Well, they could take stuff from us as well, like just being in a democracy.
American football.
Oh, yeah. Fuck yeah. Freedom.
One thing.
Freedom I think, and guns.
Birds.
American bald eagles.
Big game. I love a good big game.
Mooses.
God damn, dude. Mooses are a mystical creature.
Something, dude. Well, good old moose knuckle.
Moose knuckles.
Nothing's better. A good old moose knuckle, dude.
Camel toes.
If this video gets 100 likes, I'll name my next kid
Moose Knuckle.
Don't do that.
Moose
to him,
dash
dude.
Knuckle Pacheco.
Moose dash knuckle.
And it'd be cute. I'd just be like, come here, Dash. I don't say moose or knuckle.
Yeah, you just get rid of it at all.
Did you guys ever hear about, I don't know if it's like the people from Japan and like Korea, I don't know if there was like a war going between them or anything like that a long time ago, but something like that, they would dunk them in hot boiling water.
Yeah.
Bro. Did you guys hear
about
that?
Oh, yeah. I've heard about that, bro. That's fucking gnarly.
Scary. Have you looked up, okay, can you go on, look up Filipino bats.
It's crazy,
bats.
Bro. Bats?
Yeah.
Bro.
That's another thing.
It's
and
like
the
size of me. I'm not that tall. I'm like, you know,
see
5'6", if you see me. You know?
You see Nikki hanging upside down. It's like,
they're taller than me, bro.
Well, like, because this is one thing. Like, in America, we don't have the crazy, crazy exotic animals, right? But, like, in other countries, you could have, like, a damn, like, 80-foot python in your house.
Yeah, which is terrifying. Like,
are you more terrified of spiders or snakes, though?
Snakes.
Really?
For sure.
What if snakes had legs, though?
Oh, my God. I just shit my pants.
I just automatically shit your pants.
Dude,
ew, that gave me, like, the
sorry.
It's like,
don't look out of your chair.
There's a snake.
This is a bad pet choice.
Is this what you're looking for here? Go ahead and cut to the
yeah, left. Look how suck that big-ass sucker.
Yeah, no, dude. That's like a vampire.
Yo, why is that girl holding
that's
that?
That's like Jeepers Creepers.
It, oh, my God, it is, dude.
Ooh, yeah. Ooh, Jeepers. I wouldn't even touch any of those.
Let's go Giant Bats, Philippines.
Giant Bats.
Oh, here you go. Di Marini. That looks like a beaver with wings, dude. Look at this thing.
Can you imagine that flying in the air?
No.
That's why I'm so scared. Like, can you imagine back then, like, a pterodactyl in the sky?
Not that it's funny, but could you could you imagine a bat just swooping down and just picking up a kid?
Oh, my God.
Just like, there he goes. You know?
No, not Johnny.
Johnny.
Sorry, it's all right. We can make another one.
Says this one's 5 foot.
I told him to stay inside.
Yeah, that's his fault.
Oh, my God. Jesus. That is Jeepers Creepers, and you can't tell me otherwise.
I think they do eat bats over there as well.
I mean, if they got that much length.
Well, you
got
to think is that they eat bats. We eat possums. Like, people over here eat possums.
I do want to go. I do want to go to, like, South Korea or, like, Thailand or, like,
people eat raccoons.
Those, like, flea markets.
It's kind of weird.
The wet shops, right?
Like, they have, like, all those crickets. I don't know if I could eat crickets and all
that. Oh, God. No. Could you imagine waking up to that, dude?
I'm not going to lie to you. I'm hitting those things with a stick, dude.
I don't think that's going to do
my
much.
My next,
they're all big.
Yeah.
My next pinata things. Might look like that. Very scary.
Let's go back. Look at the nuts on this thing. I don't think we can show that on the air. But goddamn.
I mean, they are. It's
this
for.
This guy has, like, 6 of them, bro.
Research purpose.
This man's pieced up. God damn. He's packing heat.
He's got bigger nuts than I do.
Let's get out of here.
Before
we get canceled.
Before I'm torqued.
Anyway, let's bring this all the way back full circle.
Yes.
Harry Potter.
Harry Potter.
Yes,
let's see.
Yes.
I mean, you'll find those creatures in Harry Potter for sure.
For Fantastic Beasts. Here's the trailer for the new Harry Potter.
Dude, HBO Max goes hard.
So fucking torqued right now. Good old
nice motorized note.
Neville. I'm already crying.
Oh, platform was too close.
Damn, that's all we
damn.
Get.
Damn.
A little quick tease.
That was a little tease.
Oh, hold on, we got 50 seconds.
What?
Everyone's coming back.
Whoa.
Wow.
Emma Watson, who's that?
How much Hermione. How much did they have to pay for that?
A lot, probably.
Wow, it's coming soon.
Uh-huh, it's almost here. They, look, you can watch all eight films on HBO.
There you go. Nikki, I'll give you my passcode.
Oh, I have HBO Max.
Look, it's right in front of you then. And Lord of the Rings is on there, too.
It is. Just kidding. So what are your thoughts? Excited? I'm excited.
I didn't even know that happened.
Dude,
I'm
fucking stoked, man.
You're gonna be excited once you watch the movies, dude.
I want you full Harry Potter clothes when you next
home. You're gonna see me come back with glasses and, you know, full wizard hat or some shit. You know?
Next,
I don't know what they have, but
so next week after you watch some of the movies, come back and tell us what school you think you belong to, and we'll take the Harry Potter quiz to see what school you belong to.
I graduated from Canyon Springs High School.
But are you Gryffindor? That's the real question.
I've done it once or twice. But I've got Hufflepuff twice.
Oh, you're Hufflepuff. That's fine.
But it always changed.
I got Slytherin once.
You know what? Next week, I'll know exactly what you guys are talking about.
Yes, exactly. That's crazy, though. I'm really intrigued how they're bringing everyone back. Usually it sucks they bring one person back, but just to get all
the whole squad's back.
That's cool.
I'm excited.
Emma Watson. Is that girl from Superbad?
No, that's Emma Stone.
Emma Stone. I'm talking about Emma Stone.
Let's talk about Emma Stone. Okay. What is
Can we do a segment on Emma
What's
Stone?
What's her name? Well, and she's related to Spider-Man, though, right?
Emma
What's
Stone? Her?
I mean,
this
she's
here
in
goes,
the Spider-Man movies.
Emma Watson here, if you want to look at the laptop here.
Oh,
Emma
man,
Watson.
Get her off the screen.
Sorry. Jesus, sorry.
Sorry, Emma.
Sorry, Nikki's not a fan.
Emma's not watching this. Damn.
You know, Emma, come on the show.
I think Harry Potter is a sometimes Christmas movie.
I think number one is a Christmas movie for sure. I would put it in a Christmas category.
Because at some point, like maybe three out of the seven movies. Right? Oh, the original, the seven, right? I
think yes, so. There's
but
seven.
Like, there's always, they have like Christmas break in the movie.
I feel like if you're going to put the first Harry Potter in the Christmas movie, you have to put Die Hard in there too.
Okay.
It's the same type of vibes. You'll see, Nick.
We're a very good council. Yes. Like, we'll let everything.
Speaking of Die Hard, if you want to see if it makes it into our, where it sits on our tier list of Christmas movies, go to the Patreon, subscribe today. $5 gets you the whole VIP package.
Did you guys go watch any Christmas movies after that?
Yeah, I think we had... I didn't watch. What did we say I was gonna watch? Oh, Four Christmases. I did not get to watch it.
Oh yeah.
But
okay.
I did watch. I think we had The Grinch on one of them. The Grinch. I think. Nice. I don't remember. Maybe.
I'm probably gonna watch The Grinch soon.
I've been watching nothing but Christmas, bro.
I really do want to watch Four Christmases though. Like we talked about it, and it got me super excited about it.
It's funny. I like today too. We might have a Christmas movie going on while we're painting in the room.
Oh, that's good.
Straight up, dude. Make some cookies.
Oh, dude, I love Christmas treats.
Dude, that's what I'm saying, dude.
The gingerbread house?
Cocoa? Oh, did that? No, I haven't done that.
Have you seen the Oreo bread houses, whatever the hell?
Bro, you got to go to Michael's, bro. Michael's got everything you need, bro.
Okay. See, I went to Hobby Lobby.
Oh, Hobby Lobby's a good one, too.
I've never been there.
Hobby Lobby's insane.
Oh, you haven't been there? You gotta go.
All those stores are
insane. I don't know a lot of things, but I know some things.
Like Joann's. That was nuts. Shout out Cartridge Mall.
Joann's is like great value Hobby Lobby.
Yes. Hobby Lobby
is the daddy.
We'll do Craftsman's tiers later. Stores.
Craft stores tiers. we had. I said something about next week. Nikki will come. We'll do the Harry Potter quiz. Yes. See the house he belongs to. How about this week? We see you guys all watched Jersey Shore, right?
Yes. Yes.
I had saw like a clip of it on TikTok or something. It kind of got me like reminiscing of the days where, like, we would all in high school and we would always watch that show because we all did, right?
Yeah, and always going
obsessed.
I was in, like, elementary, middle
school. Yeah,
always
yeah,
going back to
he's
school.
He's a little younger than us.
Hey, he's still 90s.
Are you guys in your 30s or what?
No.
You guys,
wow. What the fuck?
I'm sorry, dude.
How old are you?
27.
I'm 28.
Yeah, see?
Nikki?
I'm 20.
He's 13.
22.
He's 13.
13. Am I 22 or 23? I don't know. I think I'm 22.
At some point, it just kind of mushes together.
You are 22.
22 years old.
Here we go, dude. So what
I
we're
know
gonna...
I look old, but...
Yeah. Well, that's not a good thing, really.
It's a lot of cigarettes, a lot of tobacco.
A lot of chew.
A lot of...
Hours in the sun.
Yeah, a lot of trauma.
A lot of working in the Spiga.
I don't want to talk about it, right?
A lot of Krampus smacking that ass.
So what are we going to... A lot of Krampus all up in that ass.
That ain't happening. That ain't happening.
It's cool if it did.
Side.
It's fine. No big deal. But anyways...
Nicky's like, halt.
We're going to do... see what Jersey Shore cast member was together.
Oh, what?
So I have three of them open, and you just kind of answer your favorite question. What's your favorite food? Nikki, you go first. Options are, I love pickles. Pasta is my favorite food. My favorite food is ravioli, but I can't eat that every day if I want to keep my abs.
Oh, wow.
Everything with some protein except fish. I love tacos, but I try to keep a keto diet. I keep healthy with veggies and soup.
Is this me?
Yeah.
Pasta is my favorite food.
All right, there's yours.
Pasta lover.
What about you, Nick?
I think I'm with Nikki.
Pasta is my favorite food.
Pasta, because I'm throwing pizza in there.
Oh, smart. Hold on, let's continue here.
Chicken Alfredo pizza.
And then, ooh, banger. For me, let's see, dude.
Pickles are way
off. I'm a pickle guy, but I also really love tacos, but try to stay keto.
Guido keto.
Yeah, I did that for a little while.
You know me about pickles.
I'm gonna say pasta, tacos over pasta every day. This is me.
Tacos over pasta?
Yes, sir.
I would eat tacos, but it says try to keep a keto diet. I don't know.
You could do that cheese tortilla.
Oh, it's there actually, and go. It's really good too.
Cheese tortilla, quesadilla.
I guess so. Yeah.
No, it's a cheese shell.
Yeah, it's a cheese shell.
Okay, so here's describe your fashion sense, right?
Oh God.
Vests are my wardrobe staple. I usually cut my shirt off. I have to wear pretty dresses. I'll wear anything short and tight. I'm very well put together. As long as it's low cut, I'm happy. So this is kind of rough for us here.
I'm going to say the bottom right.
Bottom right for you?
Yeah.
Oh, but which one was that?
Keep my short and tight.
Short and tight. I like that.
Because I'm still gaining weight, so my shirts have been tight. Really.
What about you, Nikki? I feel like you go... you're
very well put together.
Yeah, you are very well put together.
You know what I'm saying, dude?
You know what I'm saying? And me, I like to wear vests. What can I say? I'm a big-time vest guy.
You don't got your shirt off usually?
No, not typically, dude, but I will take it off.
Mine's usually in the shower.
I usually got my shirt off all the time. My shirt's off, bro.
I keep my shirt strapped.
My son taps on my belly.
Put together.
You're like, thank you.
Yeah, my son does that too.
He's
bro.
Off belly?
And
I'm
my
just like, yeah, dude, I get it, man.
No abs.
The worst part is like my son, like my wife's pregnant, right? So my son comes up to my belly and goes, "Baby," and I said, "No, you broke my heart."
A beer.
No, stop, son, please.
I did. Like, bro, come on, man. On a sunny day, on a sunny day on the Jersey Shore, what are you doing, bro?
Baby.
Getting my hair. Yeah, it's the worst. But he just comes up and he just, baby. I'm like, no. Not here. That's mommy.
Girl.
And he's like, baby. I'm like, stop it. I know.
That's so good.
So on a sunny day on the Jersey Shore, what are you doing? Getting my hair done. I'd be trying to do something fun and spontaneous. The sun's that I'm probably drinking. Oh, there we go. Probably in bed with a hangover. Probably be heading to the gym and getting a tan before doing my laundry.
Jesus.
Trying to catch a tan at the beach. For me, I'm saying I'll probably do something fun and spontaneous. That's me, for sure. Nick, what do you say?
I'm going to go probably drinking. Bottom left.
Sun's out, probably drinking. Let's go. Nick? E?
My girl tells me I'm an alcoholic, so I'll probably be drinking in the sun on the beach.
Sun's out, we're drinking.
You're only an alcoholic in the sun.
How would your friends describe right? Only on days that end with Y.
Yes. Or when I'm watching Harry Potter.
Some butterbeer.
Oh, I never had it.
Me either. We should get some.
I want to go to the Harry Potter place in London. Like the actual set thing. Uh-huh. Like they have the butterbeer.
But don't they have like Harry Potter Land at Disney World?
I know, but think of it in London.
Where it's extra Harry Potter. Extra Potter.
You're a Harry wizard.
You know my favorite meme is like you're a blizzard Harry. Anyways, dude, what would your friends describe you as?
I wish I could understand this.
You will.
You're gonna get there, Nikki.
You're gonna come over next week and be like, "You're a blizzard, Lalo." I'm like, "You're right."
You guys would be like, "Stop."
He'll say a reference, we're like, "What are you talking about?"
Dude, that doesn't make sense.
Yeah, you guys need to watch him.
Yeah, you nerds.
Yeah.
So how would your friends describe you? Honest and a mama's boy, loud and a bit intimidating but loyal, obsessed with the gym and vain, funny and a little bit ditzy, funny and always up for a party. They'd say I'm a sweetheart. Nikki, you're up first.
I'd say fun and a little bit
ditzy.
Yeah.
Okay.
What does ditzy mean, though?
It's kind of like a space case, kind of like...
Like sometimes common sense is not there.
Yeah, sometimes you're just kind of wild a little bit.
That's me, dog. You know, say that's me right there, dog.
You snooks.
Yeah, hell yeah, that's me and my wedding day.
How would they... Right.
Grenade whistle.
How would your friends describe you, Nick?
I think maybe the funny but always down to party and always down to party.
I like that one.
I'm always down to party.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And I think for me, I think loud and a bit intimidating, but loyal because like I, sometimes people like, because I like to be, I'm just a loud guy, bro. Sometimes it's scared. I like to give hugs, and people sometimes don't like hugs. Loud hugs.
You got that deep voice.
I got that motherfucking deep shit, son. Yeah,
I thought somebody else was over here. You're not scared.
Anyways, for this, it's Saturday night. You're going out. What can you be found doing?
Fucking locking my door. Turn the lights.
Dance on tables and falling over.
Oh damn!
Probably arguing with someone. Probably chatting up as many people as I can. Oh, fist pumping. Make sure my hair looks perfect before I leave the house. I'll be dead. I'm first. I'm gonna say fist pumping for sure.
Oh, on a Saturday night.
I put my fist pump, pump, pump.
Yo, we got to FaceTime Lala on Saturday night. Oh, yeah. he's gonna answer the phone. He's gonna be
in my chonies, dude.
Oh, that'd be tight.
The chonies will be tight, or what are you talking about?
They might be
both.
Torqued.
Double entendre.
Nick, what about you? What do we find you on a Saturday night?
I'm fist pumping.
Fist pumping. Let's go.
Yeah.
Nikki.
Saturday night.
Watching the Grinch.
I'd probably be arguing with somebody. I'd probably be arguing with my son, to be honest.
That's all awesome.
What are you most likely? What are you most likely to get into an argument about?
Oh shit!
Getting too drunk and behaving badly.
Uh oh.
I'll probably most likely to argue with my boyfriend / girlfriend over something stupid, for being rude to someone. Probably something to do with talking to a boy, taking a boy or girl home.
Oh jeez.
Sticking up for my friends. I try my best to stay away from arguments. Nikki.
I go with B. Try to stay out of arguments, man.
Yeah.
I don't like to argue. I like to
have a good time.
Yeah, just that. Just avoid conflict.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. What about you?
That's the same for me. Yeah. Arguments. I just want fist pump, man.
Trying to pump these fists.
If you ain't trying to pump fists,
let's see, dude.
What kind
for
of
me?
Life?
Maybe staying up for my friends.
Yeah, I could see that.
Maybe getting too drunk and behaving badly. I've been known to do that as well.
See, I almost picked that one too.
Yeah, I mean, last time I got fucking super tanked, we were at Chonies for my
birthday. Oh, damn.
Before it switched for my birthday, and dude, I was fucking gone.
What'd you drink? Pilot.
A bunch of Mother Earth's peanut butter stouts.
Oh, those are great.
Yeah, they fucking crushed me, dude. I was done for. Like, I don't remember the night at all. I woke up naked on my floor. My wife had to go to work in the morning. I was like, what happened?
She like pokes you with the stick, like, do something.
Yeah, right. Yeah, I had to get up to puke, and I just didn't make it back to the bed. So I was asleep on the floor. She put a blanket on me, so it was nice.
That reminds me when I shit my pants one time.
Dan, Pile High Club.
Were you drunk?
Yeah, well, I woke up and I'm like, wait a second.
Who shit my pants?
Who shit my pants?
Did you shit inside my pants?
Yeah. I'm walking to everyone. I text, did you happen to shit in my pants?
Oh, Kenny, did you? That's a Kenny move, dude. Kenny. Did you shit my pants?
Kenny would steal my pants, shit in them, put them back on me.
I miss Kenny, dude.
Shout out to Kenny.
Love you, dude.
Love you, Kenny.
For me, dude, let's see. I might get drunk and behave badly. Like if I.
Damn, we're going to do that one.
I think it makes sense for me, dude.
It's all right. You're the core, though. You'll be the core.
Yeah, someone's got to take care of me sometimes.
If all three of us pop out of a limo, this is what's happening.
Watch me. Watch me, dude.
If he's looking different.
What's my favorite place on the Jersey Shore?
Ooh.
The boardwalk, the club, the beach, the gym, my bed, anywhere there's a party. For me, I'm going to say my bed.
Oh, wow.
The beach or my bed. The beach or my bed.
The beach.
My bed. I'm going to stay right there.
Wow.
Yeah.
Could the beach be your bed?
Ooh, I could make a bed at the beach.
Mm-hmm.
Bash at the
or
beach.
Or bring
even.
The bitch. Bitch.
Oh, bring the bitch to the bed.
That's my favorite beach. The bitch.
Nick.
The club, I'm gonna do
the beach.
Where was it?
The boardwalk.
The boardwalk.
I like the boardwalk.
Be playing some carnival games.
Mm-hmm.
Use the Ferris
wheel. Eating a hot dog, a glizzy.
A Coney dog.
Coney dog.
Yeah.
I'm not saying the boardwalk.
I'm a big time hot dog guy, dude. Are you guys hot dog guys?
Hot dogs?
Honestly?
Yeah, but you get pissed because I hate mustard on hot dogs.
No, I don't like hot dogs.
I go straight up ketchup.
I don't be eating glizzies.
No glizzies for Nikki?
Come on.
Get over yourself.
I ain't about that lifestyle.
Well, what's a word you'd pick to describe yourself, Nikki?
Me?
Sassy, straight talking, angry, hyperactive, crazy, tough.
Honestly,
this is kind of rough.
Yeah, this is a weird one. What's that for? Oh, sassy?
Sassy, straight talking, angry, hyperactive, crazy, tough.
Is straight talking too? Like you're just straightforward and stuff?
Yeah, kind of like a ball buster is like straight talking, I feel like. I could probably put that in that category.
Okay.
What do you guys think?
Maybe. I think you're a straight talker. Yeah. You kind of keep like to the point and you like to bust people's balls.
Yeah, let's go with that.
Okay.
Yeah, that's me.
That's me. Nick, what about you?
I'm crazy.
Crazy, okay. Yeah, I could agree to that.
Yeah. Self-diagnosed crazy.
For myself, I'll say hyperactive because I've been known to jump stuff and talk too fast and say stuff that's wrong.
Damn, I just want to go to the club with you guys now.
You just want to go get fucking hammered after this?
Let's go to the getaway.
What's your favorite color?
Honestly, I like the getaway, dude.
The getaway is dope.
I've been there 3 times.
They give you like a burger and fries and a drink for like $7 or something like that.
They're going to promote the getaway.
Smack, dude.
And they are good too. Shout the getaway.
I love a burger when it smacks though.
Oh, fuck yeah, bro. Mm-hmm. It Krampus smacks my ass.
That burger could smack my ass all day.
This one's what's your favorite color? Red, yellow, probably. Neon, pink, and black.
Yellow, probably.
White and gray, pink and blue, black. I'll go first. I think these days I'm more of a white and gray guy, to be honest with you.
Dude, I like that. I feel you on that one.
Nick?
Well, we're painting our walls gray, kind of. Okay. So, but red's kind of been
your deal?
Creeping up there.
You like red?
I like red. It's Christmas.
Are you down with red? Is your favorite?
Let's go red. Okay. I'm like Cypher.
Active gay member in the building.
He put it out there. Nikki,
I'm colorblind.
Black.
Black.
Yeah,
that's you for sure.
That's a good one.
I'm a very dark individual.
If there was there blue? Was there blue at all?
I think was there. I don't think there was. No.
Yeah. Okay. See, if blue is on there,
too late.
What do housemates getting annoyed? What do you annoy the housemates? I don't fucking. That's who wrote hey, this on. Fucking question.
Hold on,
but I can't.
Let's see.
What do housemates getting annoyed at you about?
What are housemates getting annoyed about you? I guess.
What do you do that annoys your housemates? I guess.
I can get angry easily. My boyfriend and I argue all the time, and I create a lot of drama. You know who that is.
Ron, stop.
I bring home too many people. I take too long in the bathroom when getting ready. I can be quite lazy. I think too much about myself.
Ooh. Okay. I have two options.
Nikki, you're up.
Oh, fuck.
Those are some good ones, though.
Yeah, those are some.
It's kind of like sad to like, fuck, what would people get annoyed about?
I think I'm going to have to go with A, to be honest.
You could get angry?
Yeah, okay. I know it seems like I don't get angry, but there's like. Yeah, I could get pissed off.
You could Hulk out.
Nikki.
knock the fuck off. No Grinch tonight.
Turn it the fuck down.
Right?
Can you go to the bathroom? I need to take a shit.
Nick,
it's
you're
12
up.
O'clock.
Okay, there's one lazy or I'm a toss up between the lazy part and then bringing two people, like too many people to the house. Because I feel like I'd be like, come to the house, we're having a party.
Oh, okay.
I'm thinking I'm going to do that one.
Too many people?
Yeah, too many people. Okay. I'm gonna do that.
I like that one. This one, I'm going to say take too long in the bathroom to get ready, but not getting ready. I'm a long pooper, dude. I'm on that pot for a minute. You guys are going to fucking be knocking the mic. Yeah, I'm shitting.
I identify with that.
Leave me alone.
It's like what Chris Pratt says. It's like,
oh, that was a nice one. Oh.
You know when like he says it's like wiping a marker?
Sponsor us.
Pub beer.
This one
they gotta get here soon.
Yeah, they gotta get on the board ready. This one's pick your favorite quote. I hear the music, I start fist pumping, I start dancing. Cabs a hip.
That's a good one.
Get some food, feel better, drink heavily. Ooh, I like that one too.
That one's good.
Maybe I went about something the wrong way. Parties here. I feel like if you say parties here, you're kind of like an arrogant prick. This one, you only live, or you only learn, you grow, you move on. You have to push through every situation that you're in. Out of all these quotes from the show, mine is the cabs a hip.
Is there only six members, right? Most of the time?
Yes.
So I wonder if all these quotes are from one member at least.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, yeah. And except for when that one bitch there, what's her name, Angelina? She comes.
Comes and goes.
Comes and goes. You say hello. Nick.
Very good.
Favorite quote.
Okay, cabs here obviously is like one of the coolest ones. Mm-hmm. What was the
get some food, feel better, drink heavily?
Well, no, the bottom left.
Maybe I went about some things the wrong way.
I'm gonna do that one.
I think we've all been there.
Like, I think you heard me wrong on that.
Nikki.
I'm gonna have to say B. You only learn
you grow, you move on.
That's inspiring, dude. You know.
Yeah, it is. Do you need tanning?
I picture like after a long night too.
I like a
And then you're just like, you need to learn. You
right. Grow. Grow. Only yeah. move on. I like a considerable tan, but not over the top. I'm happy without a tan. I want to be tanned as possible. I have to be extremely tanned all the time. A little bit of tan is good enough for me. I always keep my tan topped up. Where are you at, Nikki, here?
I have to be extremely tanned at all the time, dude.
Oh, shit.
You know what's... Okay, why are you laughing, dude?
I don't know. I just like... You said that so confidently. I'm like, all right. I mean...
You know what's weird? Okay, look, check. I don't know if you can see this on camera, but, you know, like, my arms, they're dark, right?
Yeah, mm-hmm. yeah.
I pull up the sleeve, dog. Look at that.
Oh, yeah. Okay, yeah.
White, dude.
You got that farmer's going
dude,
on.
Dude, that's fucking insane.
I was like, my ass cheeks are as white
my
as
my thighs,
yours.
Bro. Yeah, goddamn, you don't want to even see my thighs.
I do want to see your thighs. Actually,
white thighs.
My thighs are tan because I've been known to wear some short shorts in the summertime.
Oh, okay.
I'm like a quarter mid-thigh type guy. Maybe, yeah.
No, the shorts above the knees is a good look.
It's the only way to go.
It looks good.
It's the only way. I've only been outshorted by a man one time, and his were like close to letting his nuts hang. I'm like, God damn, the guy's brave.
That is brave. You can see his moose knuckle.
He was very, he was knocked up.
He was knocked up. Damn, dude. All
right. He's a knuckleball. Wearing a cup right now.
It was a real knuckleball.
It was a real knuckleball. That's really scary.
What about you for your tan here, Nick? Tan as possible?
Tan as possible?
Keep my top, or my tan topped up?
What's like the middle right side?
Middle. I had to extremely tan all the time.
Okay, bottom one?
A little bit tan is good enough for me.
That's good, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I look like a Neapolitan ice cream. I'm just different all over now. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I like considerable tan, not over the top. I agree. A little bit of tan is good enough for me.
We all got some good tans in this room, though.
Yeah, I'm the lightest in here easily.
But I feel like we could all get dark in this.
Oh, for sure. Not me. I get a nice tan, but nothing crazy. What's my favorite alcoholic drink? Jameson. That's easy right there, off the bat. Jameson fucking smacks.
Spoke to you.
I don't need to see any of the other ones.
Jameson.
Okay, Nick, shots of tequila. I used to drink a lot of vodka, but I don't drink anymore.
Ooh.
Martinis or cocktails. Jameson whiskey is my favorite. Chocolate-covered shots, coconut rum.
Chocolate-covered shots. Holy shit.
I never had one. I don't think I ever will
you don't think it, why?
No, I don't. It just Let's sounds go to, awful.
What would you even, would you just say, I want a Hershey's shot? Like, how do you even say that?
Do you guys have a chocolate-covered shot here?
Give me Hershey's kiss.
And the bartender describes you by the shirt.
Yeah, can I get a whiskey and chocolate?
Nice. Can I get a JMO chocolate, please, over here?
JMO chocolate? That sounds good.
That sounds dope.
I would do the cocktails and martinis.
Okay, I like that. I've never had a martini.
They're, really strong.
I've been known to have a cocktail or two in my life.
And, like, the James Bond way, like, shaking, not stirring, that shit's really rough. It's really not great for me.
Nick?
I'm going to have to go with tequila, lime, no salt.
For real?
I really want to get
up.
I don't ever.
Dude, I don't do that either.
I can't. It makes it worse for me.
Have you ever had tequila with, like, an orange juice chaser?
No, I don't do chasers.
You don't do any chasers?
I've heard that pickle chasers are the way to go.
Yeah, whiskey pickleback.
Yeah, picklebacks.
No chasers for this guy. I'm tough as nails.
No one's chasing.
You're tough as the mic, the situation right here, dude.
Tough as bamboo.
Oh, shit. Look at this guy, dude.
Pick an item you can't live without. A push-up bra? I couldn't live without bronzer.
These are things you can't live without.
Can't live without.
Okay.
A fake tan. A white vest. I couldn't go without my hair gel. I couldn't live without my gym weights.
That's all wrong for me.
Same.
None of the above. Are you picking first?
Nikki's up first.
Go with fake tan.
Can't live without a fake tan.
I mean, we got to live like through Jersey, right? We got to
right.
Exactly. Okay. Think like Jersey.
You could live without your bronzer, your fake tan, a white vest, a push-up bra, hair gel. Couldn't live without your weights.
I'm gonna go hair gel.
Okay.
There you go. He got some on right now.
I don't. It's all sadly.
It's just. Gel under the stings.
For me, let's see, dude. I mean, I'm just saying bronzer. I can live without bronzer. I need that shit in my life.
Bronzer.
I don't know what it does.
Oh, shit.
But it'll do something nice to me, I'm sure. What's your favorite thing to do when you're not partying? This is a long ass question. Tell me who
sleep.
I am. I like to cook. Ooh, that's me already.
Exercising. I love
cooking. DJing or making music. Hanging out with my friends. Hanging out with my boyfriend / girlfriend. Chilling with the boys. I like to cook. That's me right there.
What is the question again?
What do you like to do when you're not partying?
I'm surprised that one answer is like still party.
Mm-hmm. Nick, this is you. Exercising, chilling with
That's
the boys.
Fake.
I like to cook. Hanging out with my boyfriend, girlfriend, hanging out with my friends, or DJing or making music.
Okay, I'm going to do hanging out. Wait, I don't know. Maybe,
Wait, what's the music one? What's the first letter? Or the word?
DJing.
DJing. I'm going to go cooking, too.
I like to cook. He's a cooking guy.
Hell yeah.
Nikki.
I don't DJ, but I do make music, so I'm going to have to go with that one.
Making music.
If I'm not doing it, if I am home, that's exactly what I'm
doing. Find Nikki's latest tape on Apple Music and all streaming platforms Pressure.
Pressure.
What's your favorite type of music?
Oh.
I like pop music on the charts. I like rap. House music is one of my favorite styles. Anything that makes me feel pumped at the gym. Anything by Drake. Anything I could dance to.
Anything by Drake.
Nikki, you're first. I think it's easy rap music.
Yeah, just rap music.
Trap music even.
Also anything by Drake.
Ooh. Close second. Pacheco yourself.
I'm going to do anything I could dance to.
Ooh, dance your little hiney off.
Mm. These ass cheeks were made for shaking.
I'm going to say rap music here. It's an easy answer, I'd say. Who would you want your best friend to be your best friend? So I think we're getting to the end here.
This is a good one, though. Because
I don't know. I guess the Jersey Shore girls. I love to be friends with Snooki. I want to be friends with everyone in that Jersey Shore house. Vinny would be my best friend. DJ Polly D would be my best friend. J-Wash, she's the best. For me, I'm going to say Vinny. Vinny's my boy, I feel like.
He's the most level-headed one.
Mm-hmm. The Keto Guido, some would say. Nick?
I'm going DJ Polly D.
Yo, what a party that guy is.
I think him and Vinny are probably the best, like, non-drama. Like, I'm like, I just want a party, dude.
They're just there for a good time. Get jacked. Nikki?
Yeah, I'm going to have to go with DJ and Pauly D.
Yeah.
DJ Pauly D.
Yes, sir.
Pick your dream holiday destination.
Gabsy.
There's nowhere better than Jersey Shore. Italy, obviously. The Caribbean.
Ooh.
Anywhere warm. Ibiza, so I could DJ my music. Miami, definitely.
Mm.
I'm going to have to go anywhere warm.
Anywhere warm. I like that answer. Nick?
I'm going Miami, definitely.
Oh, my shit. Miami.
Welcome to Miami. Shout out to Will Smith.
Love you.
Down, down with the beat is on.
Love you, Will.
I would say Italy.
Italy?
Yeah, we're going.
Hey, pasta.
Going overseas.
Pasta,
pizza, party, baby.
Gelato.
Ooh. I didn't even read the question there.
I want to name my next dog Gelato.
Pick your favorite quote again.
Another quote.
The youngest guy in the house, but I'm the most mature person in the house. Jim Tan Laundry. I'm like a praying mantis. You spilled the haterade. I need closure, bro. I have an education. I went to college, you know. I am like a praying mantis. I like that one.
Praying mantis.
Nick?
I'm doing that one that said the...
Closure?
No.
Haterade?
Yeah, Haterade. Yeah, that one. I like that one. You spelled the Haterade.
Nikki?
I'm going to have to go with... I need closure, bro.
I feel like that's a real Ron quote there.
Yeah.
What's your favorite sport? I don't like sports. Is Jets king a sport? Running, I guess. Is gym a sport? It's got to be basketball. Oh, where the fuck?
Is gym a sport?
I don't care about sports unless there's someone attractive playing.
Jesus.
So this is me, right?
That's so
Jersey.
Yeah,
it's you, Nikki.
Basketball, man.
Nice.
All the way.
Oh, shit. It's not letting me switch.
Once again, not American football's on.
I fucked up for you. I guess gym's a sport. That's yours. Sorry, Nikki.
Hell yeah, brother. Gymnastics.
Get yoked.
Is gym a sport? I like to lift weights. Nick, pacheco yourself.
I'm going basketball.
It's got to be basketball.
Playing basketball.
Mm. Basketball for me as well. That's the only one.
That's the only one that maybe.
Yeah, I guess that I tickles just my gym. Pickle.
Unless we all just pit.
Who's your favorite Jersey Shore cast member? What if like you go all through these questions, but like this one is what decides
who
you are.
All this was bullshit.
Uh-huh. It is probably. Vinny's my fave. I'm a big Vinny guy.
God.
How fucking long is this thing, dude? I'm sorry, guys. I thought this would be fun and fast, but it's not. I hope you guys are having fun listening to this. Nah, Nick.
They got to. It's nostalgic.
Your favorite member.
I'm going the situation.
Ooh, dude.
He's hilarious.
The snitchuation? The snitchuation?
The situation.
Nikki?
I'm going to have to go with Snooki, dude.
Oh, ooh, big Snooki guy.
Yeah.
Snooki is fun. I mean, for her to get punched in the face.
Yo, she got fucking, bro. She got
and
rocked.
Then she's like, fuck off. She's like, little.
And then she's still fist bumping.
Yeah, she's still fist bumping.
Your least favorite cast member?
Oh.
Everyone. I try to get on with everyone, but Angelina and Ronnie wind me up. Sammy Sweetheart, Ronnie, Angelina. I like everyone, to be honest, and JWoww.
Ooh.
Okay. You're first. Yeah, she's the fucking worst.
Fuck that.
You're a dirty little hamster.
I'm doing the... Is it me?
Yeah, you.
I'm going to do the one where, like, I try to get along with everyone, but...
Actually, yeah, right. That's fair.
Like, they're back at it.
Yeah, remember when Ronnie fucking knocked that dude out on the boardwalk?
Yeah. Remember when,
one punch, son!
Remember when Situation
I'm
tried to,
Angelina
like...
as well. For me, fuck Angelina. Go ahead.
Situation tried to fight Ron.
And oh, and knocked himself out?
God.
How do you feel about drama? Normally, oh, I'm God. The one... Normally, I'm the one creating it. I find it funny as long as I'm not involved. Drama seems to be following me around. I don't like drama, but I seem to cause it. I used to enjoy drama when I was younger. It's funny to watch a drama unfold. Sometimes I stir drama up, too. I think I find it funny as long as I'm not... Drama's actually super fucking annoying, but they don't have an answer for that one.
I know, right?
So I'm going to say it's funny as long as I'm not involved. Fucking hell. How many more questions?
I'm doing the same.
Okay.
Just because, like, the drama, even, like, Soulja Boy is my favorite drama.
Oh, true. Drake!
There, yo, funny. I saw this one thing, and he's like, yeah, I got co-signed for my shoes. Oh, who co-signed you? He's on me. He's
freaking soldier. Nikki, drama.
Drama. I think it's funny as long as I'm not in it.
Yeah, for sure.
Not that I like drama, but you know.
Yeah, as long as it's not me, I could watch from the outside laughing. I'm in for it, bro.
Yeah, I freaking hate drama.
Nikki, do you make a good impersonation? I'm not sure, probably not. Yes, I come across very sweet. I don't think I make a good initial impression before people can realize I'm crazy. I like to think so. I try to come off happy all the time. I don't think so. Yes, I'm very good at talking to parents and older people too. Okay.
Jesus. Just stand up.
Wait, hold on. What is...
You want me to read him again?
No, I'm not sure. No. What was the question?
Do you make a good impersonation?
Impersonation?
Yeah.
First impression?
Yeah, impression. Oh, impression. My fucking mess.
Oh, okay.
Hyperactive brain.
I want to go with B. Yeah, I'm very good at talking to parents and older people.
There we go. Mr. Nick?
I do the one they find out I'm crazy.
I make a good initial impression, but people realize I'm crazy.
Yeah. But acceptance, right?
Mm-hmm. Yep. Yeah, for mm-hmm. sure. Thank you. You know your stuff.
You guys are my friends.
Let's see. I think I come across very sweet. That's my opinion of myself.
I agree.
How do you style your hair? This is fucking rude.
How do you do it, Lalo?
Damn, dude.
I want to know your secret.
Let's see.
Do you start off with a nice hair gel in the morning?
I have a signature over the stop style poof hairstyle.
I think that's you.
I keep my hair as long as possible. Also me. Mm-hmm. I keep my hair short so there's no maintenance.
No, that's not you.
Hey, that's pretty.
I have the perfect blowout.
Damn.
I like to play around with hair color and highlights. I also like to do that. I keep my hair short, but I use gel to spike it up. I think the only one that makes sense is there's no maintenance.
Yeah.
I do have a perfect blowout, though. Nick, your hair.
What's that middle left one?
I keep my hair short, but I use to gel to spike it up. I use gel to spike it up.
Let's just do that one. That one seems great.
I like where that one's going.
I just don't never spike my hair.
Nikki?
I'm going to go with E. I keep my hair as long as possible.
Hey.
You are growing your hair out. It's looking nice.
I mean, you can see the back now. You can't really see it.
Damn.
Yeah, look at it. Ooh. It's flaring out. Oh, I see that.
Almost turned a nice blowout.
I'm a fan of that. It's almost a blowout.
I don't got a mullet, though. I'm not trying to have a mullet.
We're about to get a little sus here.
Uh-oh.
Which Jersey Shore do you think is most attractive?
Ooh.
None of them? Okay, there we go.
Okay.
Ronnie, Pauly D all the way. Pauly D or Vinny, I can't decide. Vinny, Mike the situation.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm going to have to go with none of them.
All right. Okay.
No such things happening around here.
I'm going...
Check yourself.
I'm going DJ Pauly D. That confidence, you know?
I don't judge.
Pauly D all the way.
He commands a room.
Oh,
he
shit. He does,
dude. For me, I'm going to say Pauly D or Vinny. I can't decide. I like both those. They're fun.
They're both? Yeah.
They're fun. I like their fucking personalities. Those are the type of dudes I like to hang out with.
Who can I go to?
Like about Lalo. He don't judge by looks.
Yeah. No. Who can I go to the village with
and have a good outcome? Who can I go fist pumping with?
Yes, exactly. Yes.
Which Jersey Shore girl do you find most attractive? Is my wife an answer here? Sammy Sweetheart, JWoww, probably Sammy Sweetheart or JWoww. JWoww or Snooki, I guess I'd pick Snooki.
None of them. Hey, there you go.
Yeah, that's a none of them for me. It's short and sweet. But check yourself.
I'm going to speak for my high school self. Uh-huh. And I'm going to go JWoww.
JWoww.
She looked like she could fight for me.
She would fight for you.
Like, I'd be out.
Snooki would get knocked out.
I'd pick a fight and then I'm like, don't let my girlfriend beat your ass.
So listen, let me get her over here.
Yeah.
Nikki,
I'm gonna have to say none of them, man. I find all of them so fucking annoying, bro.
Yeah,
that's true.
That just turns it off. If you're annoying, you talk, you super loud, man. That just turns it off for me, man. I'm just like, dude, just chill out, man.
Just shut the fuck up.
Yeah, I didn't want to say that, but yeah,
I'll say it for you. Bro. That's fine.
Just thanks, like, man.
What's your favorite scene from the Jersey Shore?
When
J-Ross speaks to Snooki's boyfriend Emilio on the phone. Don't remember that. When Vinny gets his ear pierced. When Paula D sings "It's T-shirt Time." When J-Wall punched Mike. Fire scene. When Sammy receives the anonymous letter. Ooh, the letter. When Mike, the situation, puts pickles under Snooki's bed. This one's you, Nikki. What's your favorite one? It's T-shirt time. When J-Y punched Mike? Yeah. That's, I like that one. That's, she fucking rocks him, too. God damn, there's another question. I'm so sorry, guys. Nikki, Nick, you're up.
I'm going to go the T-shirt time.
Oh, for sure. It's T-shirt. It's still said to this day by people.
Still to this
day. I'm going to say T-shirt time as well.
Still singing this in who else is singing this in 2021?
How do you get ready for a party? Ooh, okay.
I get nervous.
Sure, I've got my best hoops earrings.
Ooh.
The highest heels on. I top up my tent, put on makeup, and I'm ready to go. Spend the whole day preparing. Going to the gym is the most important part of my routine.
Jesus.
I make sure my hair looks sleek, that I've got a pretty dress to wear. I pick up my best T-shirt. I'm ready to go. I take hours to get ready, and my hair takes the longest. I'm just going to pick up my best T-shirt. That's kind of my deal. God damn, pick a final call. Oh, I think we're almost there.
Ooh.
Okay, Nick, what's your how do you get ready for the party?
I'm wearing my highest heels.
Oh, fuck yeah, you are. And I like that
My pumps.
Nikki, how do you get ready for a party?
And I could just be taller than anyone.
I think you're probably going to say best T-shirt. Ready to go?
Yeah. Honestly.
Yeah,
that had shoes on there. I'd be shoes.
Yeah, that wasn't
a take t-shirt, a final,
which is weird.
This is the final quote.
Yeah, so here we go.
Oh,
it's probably
shit.
The best.
All the other quotes,
right? This is probably the best accomplishment I've had in a long time. To kick the shit of Jenny. I don't wear too much jewelry. I just keep it simple. Maybe wear a little chain. When people function this early in the morning, this isn't real life to me. I feel like it's a video game. We just got chemistry, you know, and I'm not talking about the class. You don't come in here on Sunday with a big banana, expect everything to be peaches. I don't follow trends to set my own and go for the extreme. Nikki, what's your?
I'm going to have to go with B.
B?
Yes, sir.
Don't follow trends?
I don't follow trends, man.
Oh, you're almost there. Oh, ooh, you're Sammy Sehart.
Wow.
Oh, shit.
You're Sammy Sehart.
Ron,
I just
stop.
Got the bag.
Sweetest bitch you ever meet.
You know what I'm saying?
The Nikki Sehart.
All right. We're about to find out who you are, Nick.
I'm going to go with the video game one.
Yeah, that's inappropriate. That here we go. The big reveal. You're J-Wow.
Oh,
you got fire tits.
Fuck yeah, dude. Shout out Roger.
Big shout out to Roger, bro.
I think they're divorced now, so my bad.
Maybe not. Maybe not shout out Roger.
You think they were forced into this shit? You know, like to get married?
Right.
You know, like,
I think it's
know,
good for
dude.
The producers thing.
Listen, you guys should really just think
about
it.
I'll give you $1 million if you marry him.
Just do it, bitch. Like, goddamn, fuck, sure.
It's your fucking life. That's yeah, right?
I'll take 20%.
Mine? Don't come here on Sunday.
Be?
Don't come here on Sunday at the Big Banana Expect.
Damn.
I like that one.
I see it. Okay.
Who is Lalo?
Who am I?
Come on. Oh, Vinny!
Yes.
Let's go!
Next time we go out to the clubs, we only go by our jersey names.
You guys want to go out tonight?
Yeah, I'll be like, my
so
name.
Hit us up if you guys want to come out, go out with Vinny, J-Wow, and Sammy Sehart.
Let us know who you got. Bring up the link.
You know what I'm saying? We can meet up at the getaway.
Yeah.
We can get away for a little bit.
Nice to meet you. I'm N-Wow.
Yeah, N-Wow, right?
N-Wow.
That's Nikki Sehart.
Nikki Sehart.
And I just keep Vinny, I guess, because yeah. Lenny sounds weird.
Lenny.
Like, what is that? A Mice of Men, right?
Yeah.
Or,
oh, yeah.
I don't want to be Lenny.
Yeah. You get put about in the woods. Just get shot.
So I'm just Vinny.
Ooh, Vinny's dope. Vinny's dope.
Anyways, let's wrap it up right there. Vinny, Nikki Sehart, and N-Wow.
N-Wow.
Peace now. Thanks for everyone who tuned in. Make sure you guys sign up for the Patreon www.patreon.com/surfacewavepodcast.
He got it.
Let's go, baby.
Yeah.
And if you sign up today through the end of December, you'll get the whole VIP package, even if you sign up for the $5 tier. If we get to our goal of 15 patrons, we will let the patrons help us decide our next design for the t-shirt.
Hell yeah.
That's me signing off. Nick, anything any last words?
It's just $5, you know? Like, you could have the Wendy's Biggie Bag Mill, whatever, mm-hmm. or Patreon. That Wendy's is always going to be here. This deal's never going
to
be.
It's limited time only. Nick, anything
balls
to say?
In your court.
I just want to say, dress down. You guys are good to go.
Let's wrap it right there.
Peace.
Boom. Peace.